Richard Cormenal in his global rule set debut.
Tonon comes out switching stances. I want to see him throw a punch. Can he throw those hands like he can attack those legs?
10-week camp for Tonon, said the majority of camp was shoot boxing.
Cormenal's got to be very careful. He's always got to be looking for the takedown. See, you can see Tonon threaten a little bit to roll there. Now he's approaching. He's trying to box into the takedown.
If it goes to ground, look for Tonon to try and slap on the inside heel hook. It's his specialty in grappling. He's submitted 35% of his opponents in BJJ with the inside heel hook. High knee! High kick! Tonon with the striking early here, going up high.
This is a lot more striking than I anticipated. Tonon looks very relaxed. He's got some awkward head movement. He's using his entire body to avoid these shots, but he's moving quite comfortably on his feet.
Tonon switching stance, takes an outside leg kick, moves that leg to the back. Constantly between southpaw and orthodox here is Tonon, trying to confound Cormenal. And Cormenal looking relaxed. As long as it stays on the feet, Cormenal's a happy man. Defends the high kick with a forearm guard, gets out of the way of the jab. Tonon switches to orthodox stance.
See Tonon trying to throw the jab, but he immediately backs off, not really putting his punches together in combinations, but he is getting time on his feet, and that's what people wanted to see. How was Garry Tonon going to react when he had punches coming at him? And he just reacted quite well as Cormenal caught him on the chin there.
Cormenal's got some very heavy hands on him. Also got some very good submission skills, though I doubt we're going to see him submit Garry Tonon. There's nothing Cormenal will pose in the submissions that Tonon hasn't seen at least a dozen times. But this is where Cormenal wants to keep it. Standing, striking range. Overhand right, no left hook for company, though, from Richard Cormenal.
Tonon really hasn't even attempted a takedown. You can see him taking the leg kick and kind of riding with the leg kick, just kind of bending down, alleviating some of that pressure. But if Cormenal follows that leg kick up with a nice right hand, he could catch Tonon. But Tonon caught him there with a left hook.
Got to be careful when he gets on the inside of Cormenal's elbows. He knocked out Tarantino with elbows in the second round back in 2016. It was a fantastic display. That uppercut from Tonon almost took out the ring lights.
That's half the round on the feet. This is not what I expected Tonon to be doing.
Hands around the waist, confidence oozing here on Garry Tonon in the striking, surprisingly.
Yes. Who would have thought that Garry Tonon would be a striking half the round in?
Is Garry Tonon maybe looking for the Go Daddy knockout of the night?
He would break the internet if that happened, Michael.
Cormenal. Looking through his brow, as well he should, trying to cut off the footwork here of Tonon. Want to keep attacking that lead leg of Tonon, it'll make it harder for Tonon to shoot in on him. Also harder for Tonon to box, the more you can damage the legs. Jab from Cormenal, uppercut. Is this a case of Garry Tonon testing his skills in an area he doesn't usually compete at?
I completely think that's what it is. He's getting time in the stand-up. I don't think he feels threatened by Cormenal's takedown. He hasn't been hurt by anything, really. And there's the takedown. That's what everybody wanted to see. This is a bad spot for Notorious to be in. He's got to keep it tight and hope for a stall. He's got to try to stall the action, keep Garry Tonon nice and tight, not give up one of those legs, because Tonon is a leg lock wizard. We saw him submit Shinya Aoki in their grappling match just a few months ago with a beautiful inside heel hook.
Tonon not going to allow Cormenal up here. Tries to plow into the guard with an overhand right. Cormenal springs to his feet. Nice work from the Filipino. Under a minute remaining in a very entertaining opening round.
The big kibosh! Here comes Tonon! The ground and pound! The aggression from Tonon! That was a huge shot that landed! And Cormenal's still here! Cormenal's got a chin!
Cormenal is game! He is in it still! He was rocked by a huge punch from Garry the Lion Killer Tonon as Tonon rains down the shots!
And look at Tonon unloading now on Cormenal. Another overhand right. Garry Tonon, house on fire. But Cormenal's still here. Ground and pound again from the American.
Cormenal's got to move. He's got 10 seconds to survive.
Cormenal taking shot after shot from Tonon in the final seconds. Olivier Cost right on top of the action. Is Tonon going to finish it? No.
from Garry Tonon. Left hand uppercut, riding the leg kicks, throwing kicks of his own. There was the takedown. That's where I thought it was the beginning of the end, but no, Tonon wanted to strike. Watch this punch. Boom! Big right hand crumbles Notorious as Tonon starts throwing leather. Oh my lord, Michael!
You've got to remember, Kormanul's had more than 76 kickboxing and Muay Thai contests. He has faced some of the most ferocious hitters on the planet. The man has a chin of granite, because a lesser man would have been knocked out by that huge strike of Garry Tonon. Tonon is flying with confidence. Second round set for three inside the massive Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand.
Right, ready?
Playing host to the largest martial arts organization on the planet. It's ONE Championship.
Garry Tonon with a near TKO finish. Who'da thunk it?
A near contender for GoDaddy knockout of the night. Now let's see what Kormanul can do, because Garry Tonon is on song, on the money thus far. A high kick. Just upends himself.
He's trying to elevate a little bit because of the height of Notorious. He's trying to reach that head with a big head kick. Just foot caught up under him a little bit. Good defense from Notorious. Oh, he is so dangerous when he gets into the clinch. He's going to try to inside reap that leg there. Yep, just like that. Brains it, goes to the outside rather this time. Now in the half guard of Notorious.
Garry Tonon in top position. So many options available for the grappling whiz from here. Huge submission ratio in his BJJ competition. Can he start his global rule set career with the submission of Richard Kormanul? Might be a lot for the ground and pound instead. Showing heavy hands tonight, Garry Tonon.
He's very comfortable from the top position. Look at him striking from the top. Takes the back, now he's in side control.
This is Tonon land. This is Tononville, and Kormanul is trapped.
Now he's got neon belly, slides into the mount. Look at Kormanul trying to flow, trying to move. But Garry Tonon is just all over him. Every move that Kormanul is trying to do, Garry Tonon is just one step ahead of him, like a grandmaster in chess.
But Kormanul's still here. Tonon, what's he sitting up for now? Another aggressive position from the American. He starts the ground and pound assault. Big elbow drops down to the nose. There's one to the forehead. There's a right to the orbital. Kormanul taking shots, taking a beating now. Gives his back. Oh, this is danger.
What the finish?
This is trouble. It could be the beginning of the end. You don't give your back to Garry Tonon, but somehow Kormanul back on his feet.
Tonon is trying to set a precedent. He is not just a one-dimensional grappler. He is a complete martial artist. He is trying to put the lightweight division on notice that Tonon has arrived. He's showing us a huge skill set right now.
Are you surprised at the resilience and the escaping so far of Kormanul, though?
Kormanul knows what's at stake here. The world is watching this match, so he knows he has to give it every ounce of determination and heart that he has, and he's doing that. He's eating some big shots that would have dropped any other lesser opponent, but Kormanul is in there, hanging tough.
Good popping right hand there from Garry Tonon. His ground and pound has been on point tonight. Up kicks trying to push him off, for his Kormanul wants to spring to his feet. The Filipino, Tonon won't let him. Drills in that left hand. There's another one from Garry Tonon. Slaps the legs away to go to side control. Is Kormanul going to give his back here? Garry Tonon.
Oh, beautiful. He was attempting to possibly go for the banana splits there. He was had him with his legs locked up. Kormanul scrambled out of it. Now he's in side control. And you know what? I don't know why we're so surprised that Tonon is demonstrating these skills. Look who is in his corner, Michael. We've got John Donaher. We've got Tom DeBlast coaching Garry Tonon in every aspect. Now he's in mount dropping bombs.
Debut.
Hey, just throw the people's elbow. Is that what I just saw in you right there? Garry Tonon looking tremendously impressive in his debut in ONE Championship. Welcome to the Global Rules Set, Garry Tonon.
An elated corner, an elated Tonon. A magnificent performance from Tonon, Mitch.
You know, you could just see him. He didn't want to finish with a submission. He wasn't trying to grapple. He was trying to throw shots. He was trying to get the knockout. He wanted to finish this by knockout. Not just sword, but not just grapple. We thought he was going to do. I thought he was going to dive for a leg, but no. He barely attempted the takedowns. He was running over Cormanol. Very impressive debut from Garry Tonon.
And let's go to Dominic Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 40 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Garry Tonon!
Garry Tonon put on one of the greatest global rule set debuts we've ever seen. Last time out against Richard Cormanol. He outstruck Cormanol and worked him on the ground, and he hits a right hand to the jaw early.
Rahul's got to be careful. He's got to keep that distance and make sure he utilizes that reach, because I think Tonon is going to want to get some striking experience here. Look at him. He's on his bicycle moving around.
But Tonon's got to be careful not to get overly confident, because Raju does have power in that right hand. And he's got reach. And you see it again used there.
You can see Rahul just waiting to time that right hand. As Tonon's starting to close in, he's landed that big right hand, but
Tonon with a cutting side kick to the midsection. There's the right hand from Raju. And Tonon keeping the gloves up high now. Connects with a left hook.
Nice hook.
High up on the balls of his feet is Garry Tonon. Got to be careful of the counter right hand from the Indian. Tonon looking to control center cage, probing with the lead hand, drifts off to the left side of Raju, lands it right in his own. Raju backs him up now. Tonon got to be careful not to drift off to his left. Ducks under, there's the takedown from Tonon, and now we're in Tonon view. Now we're in Tonon land. This is Lion Killer territory.
Oh, nice use of the wizard there by Raju, trying to get back up to his feet, and he does.
Now that's going to surprise some people, the fact that Raju got back up to his feet very quickly.
Now he needs to create a little bit of space. Tonon's got good wrestling. He's very strong when he attacks that single leg. Raju's got to keep that wizard, how he has that right arm overhooked over Tonon's arm. He's got to keep that jacking him up, make sure that Tonon can't level change. Oh, he doesn't need to. He trips the outside leg.
Nice work there from Tonon. Raju posting up on the right arm, looking for a way back to his feet. Playing a game for wrist control here.
Oh, nice roll, and he traps the leg in the roll. Beautifully done. This is a bad spot.
This is a Tonon specialty. Can he take the leg home?
Oh, but he's got to be careful. He's got to push. He's got to get that knee out of danger. That's a bad spot.
This could signal pain for Raju. All tied up like a pretzel.
Look at the leg entanglement by Garry Tonon. The way he has his legs crossed, completely isolating that leg. Raju's got to create space. He's got to move. He's got to get his knee out of the hip. Oh, good job.
And Raju's through. How about that from Rahul Raju? And now he's got top position. Can he sling the legs a little of Garry Tonon?
Oh, he's putting the fire. He's got to let Garry Tonon back up to his feet.
The confidence must be oozing from Raju after that escape. He slings the legs now. And is he going to get himself into trouble playing this game? Up kick there from Tonon.
You can hear Raju's coach, Arvin, screaming to let him up.
Rahul Raju showing he's not going to be a pushover. He's not going to be easy pickings. He's not going to go quietly into the night. And Tonon, high on the balls of his feet, probing with that lead hand. Southpaw stance for the American. Throws the outside.
Careful again with the inside heel hook.
Oh no!
He's got to be, he's got to okay. Right now you can see that the ankle is not necessarily, there he is. He's able to pop it out by a little bit of hand fight right there. But you can see the way that Tonon is controlling the legs, or the leg rather, with the leg entanglement, how his legs crossed over. Raju's got to explode right here. He's got to create a little bit of movement. Got to get out of this.
This is what Raju said he'd been working on for the last couple of months. Said he'd studied the leg locks, researched the Danaher material, trained leg locks at 10th planet. And then back to their feet. Uppercut there from Raju.
Raju gets out of two leg entanglements with Garry Tonon. That's got to be a victory all in itself. 20 seconds left in the first round as Garry Tonon transitions to mount.
Full mount now for the American. Garry Tonon in control. But confidence boosting round for Rahul.
Look at this, look at the way Tonon's crouching in, a little bit of a la Mike Tyson a little bit as he came in looking for that big left hook. There he is, lands in a right hand, but Raju coming right back with a combination of his own. Look at the way Tonon changes levels, slides underneath and lands a big takedown. Good round for Garry Tonon, but I am so shocked that Raju got past two leg entanglements and survived the heel hooks of Garry Tonon.
Unbelievable. Okay. Rahul Raju, that extensive camp, hanging up. Now, this is the round that Raju said he would knock out Garry Tonon with. He said he'd connect with the right hand. He did on a few occasions in the first. Can he find a clean one here in the second? And Garry Tonon said, either ground and pound, or I may just take his leg home. Ooh, got to be careful not to drop the hands coming in. You saw Raju pump the right hand down the center corridor. A flying side kick there from Tonon. A high side kick from Tonon.
Tonon's kind of letting his creativity come out as he starts throwing these kicks.
There's the right hand, it backs up Tonon. And Raju controlling center cage. Tonon on the outside, using all these angles.
Tonon can throw these leg kicks because, or these leg shots, because he's not scared of the takedown from Raju. But Raju, if he could time that right hand, right as Garry Tonon's coming in.
I lift roundhouse kick. Worked with many high-level strikers in preparation for this one, did Tonon. Rahul Raju showing patience here. Knows that he wants to see the opening for that big right hand.
You can see the way he comes in, like zigzagging in between to try to create those angles to land that big kick. But what he's doing out there is he's getting valuable minutes in an area where he's not very accustomed to. So he's trying to be creative and trying to express himself in a somewhat unorthodox manner. But we can see him switching stances and marching forward.
Raju tries to take his head off of the roundhouse. Now they're back on the ground. Tonon top position.
Tonon is a world champion black belt on the ground, so that's a whole different level. Look how he cradles the leg and arm right there. Raju looks like there could be a choke in as he transitions into mount. Look how he wraps that leg up. That's a tight squeeze right there. He's going underneath the arm.
Look to finish.
So many possibilities available to Tonon. Raju back to his feet again. Tonon hooks the leg.
Tonon's trying to take the back. Raju keeps his back pressed up against the cage, and he's able to circle out again. Another moral victory.
Winning over portions of the crowd here in Manila for his amazing ability to constantly get back to his feet. Tonon resets. Throws a right hand. There's a roundhouse kick from Raju. Tonon switching between southpaw and orthodox. Lots of movement from the American halfway through the contest. Raju got that right hand cocked and ready.
And I like how he's keeping his hands low. Just maybe be a little bit more cautious. cautious of the takedown that he believes is inevitably coming.
Uppercut from Tonon. Didn't find the target though. Resets again, does Tonon. Raju trying to maintain his authority in center cage. Throws the right hand, so too does Tonon. Neither man connects cleanly.
Instead of going for the big head kicks, I'd like to see Garry Tonon start attacking the legs of Raju. Raju's got a very wide stance, and that lead left leg is wide open for a couple of either calf kicks or thigh kicks, where Tonon could start landing a lot of shots.
Tonon looking very relaxed, very at ease. Only his second match under this global rule set. Superb debut against Richard Cormanal last time out. Good left hand there from Tonon. There's another left from the American.
That's what Raju's got to do. He's got to start putting out that jab. Tonon's closing the distance, coming right into punching range. What's a perfect shot that he could throw? Boom, he could land either the left straight jab or a nice right uppercut.
Wild right hand there from Raju. Tonon with the head movement, snakes his way out of trouble. Now he's got center cage, throws the right hand down the center corridor. Good evasion from Tonon, the head movement again. Outside leg kick from Raju. And Tonon in southpaw stance. Threads an uppercut, snaky and cagely. Raju's got to throw that right hand, especially when Tonon goes to southpaw. Front kick from Tonon, belly button through the back. Front kick again, a little higher there from Tonon. Under 20 seconds remains. The confidence in Tonon's striking ability growing by the minute. Now comes Raju on the front foot, Tonon with the uppercut. Backs off Tonon with the left hand, does the Indian. And we've got one more round to go, Dragon.
You're right, Tonon's confidence is growing because the shots that Raju's hitting him with really aren't doing any damage. Raju's just kind of in there, a little bit throwing a little bit of shots, but that was a beautiful uppercut. I like the way Tonon's coming in, and you know he lands a nice left hook there, but I like the way he's changing angles. He's coming in, and he's zigzagging left and right, just like Mike Tyson. Tonon told me he went and studied high-level strikers, and he liked the way Tyson moved and landed that left hook. He hasn't really gone to the body much, but he is moving very well, and his head is always off-center. He's never dead in straight line.
Three world champions amongst our many luminaries, Kang Sai, Chongqing Nan, Viviano Fernandez, and Brandon the Truth Vera. It's a sellout here at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. It's the hottest ticket in Manila. It's one championship, Reign of Kings. Olivia Cost to get us underway. Third and final round. Will the right hand of Raju prevail?
I would imagine, yeah, we're done with the strike. Tonon wants to get the win, get this to the ground as quickly as possible, and lock on a submission and finish Raju, because he's not going down from the shots that Tonin's landing.
This is Tonon's territory. Top position on the ground. So many options available for the grappling megastar.
Raju's got to start pushing that head down. He can't allow Tonon to drive his head up into his face like that. That's uncomfortable, but it's also going to control his position. Raju's got to start pushing that face away and create a little bit of space. Tonon sucked his hips away. Now he's easily able to transition into, what's he got, full mount there? Almost half guard, but easily cuts through that. Look, here comes a triangle possibly.
Raju has shown his toughness to survive several heel hit attempts thus far. The arm is pinned. The face is exposed. And there's a couple of left hands to the shoulder. There's another plaza. Over the shoulder. Locks it up to Raju. And Raju's free again.
Let Tonon stand back up. Good job again.
The resilience of this Indian is phenomenal.
He might be losing on the scorecards, but he is winning fans worldwide by surviving Garry Tonon's submission attempts.
Escapes aplenty from Rahul Raju of India. And Tonon back to dancing, back to switching stance. Raju's going to try and catch him with that piston-like right hand. And Tonon circles off to his right, going counterclockwise. Raju probing with the lead hand. The left to probe, the right to damage. There's the right. Tonon on the balls of his feet. Comes out the jab. There's a hook, but the shoulder protection up in a hurry. Raju should have thrown the right hand. It was a golden opportunity. He may rue the missed opportunity. Double leg takedown from Tonon.
Yeah, that's what Tonon was talking about all week. It's his shoot boxing, putting these things together. And he considers a takedown just one of the many weapons in his arsenal in combinations. One, two, takedown, get back up, ground and pound, consistently pressuring Raju. Now he's gonna take the back. These guys are slippery now. Looks like he's gonna take the back there. He might go for an arm. Look how he's isolating the arm there. He's trapped that arm. There's a possible scramble if Raju can turn in. He's gotta go chest to chest to get out of this. Tonon's got great back control, though. Look how he isolates that arm. Traps the arm with the leg. Now he's going to be able to go underneath the chin.
Oh, Raju in trouble! In big trouble!
Look how Tonon hides the hand so Raju can't defend it.
In huge trouble!
That's a face crank. That's nasty. Raju fighting his way out!
He escaped it again!
Move with a knife, but as he isolated that arm, he trapped that right arm. Look at that. Uses his legs to trap the arm of Raju and snuck the arm under the chin. Beautiful. That right there has to be the Red Horse move of the night. But gotta give it up to Rahul Raju to survive so many attempts. He looked good in the process, Michael.
It is Tonon's victory, but also a victory for Raju on so many levels.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 27 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Garry Tonon!
Here they go in the first round. Gafurov, the former world champion in the black. This one, mixed martial arts global rule set, 3 by 5 minute rounds. Behind Moushigo roundhouse kick from here. Kyokushin black belt, Matsushima.
Matsushima's doing a good job. He's circling to the weak side of Gafurov. Gafurov likes to set up that big takedown with a huge overhand right. So Matsushima's backing up, moving away.
Kyokushin karate developed by Sosei Masayama, who passed away in 1993. Renowned as the hardest form of karate. Masayama, the only man to ever complete a 300-man kumite. 100 opponents every day for 3 days, and he beat them all. Moushigo again there from Matsushima.
He likes that diving in, left high, left kick. Likes him maybe go after the legs a little bit. Start setting up that leg kick, throw those punches. Gafurov's going to try to close the distance, yep.
Gafurov is known for his submission grappling, but he does have a background in striking. Started in Wushu Sander in 2002. He's also done Pancration, Sambo, and BJJ. Nice check there from Gafurov. High lift roundhouse kick from Matsushima. Gafurov back to center cage. Matsushima said he'd studied a lot of tape of Gafurov, knows he has to be careful of Gafurov's pressure style. 4 week training camp for Matsushima. And there's a high lift roundhouse kick from Gafurov.
Keeping his hands nice and tight to his chin, especially when he starts to back away from Gafurov. Gafurov is enabling, you know, he's landing a lot of that leg kick too.
Gafurov also has a way of getting inside his opponent's heads. The surprising given that Gafurov holds a degree in psychiatry.
Matsushima taking Gafurov down.
Gafurov swinging wildly the right hand as he bounded back up. Approaching the halfway mark of this opening round under mixed martial arts global rule set. Resets here to Vic Yokushu Karateka, goes to the legs. Matsushima known for its powerful roundhouse kicks. Also for its Chudansuki reverse punches to the midsection.
Ooh, ooh! Oh,
from Matsushima! And he rushes Gafurov. Gafurov over the whole lot of trouble. And it's over. That's a shot. A world championship debut. The power of Kyokushin Karate prevails in Jakarta.
Oh, my! Matsushima just shocked the world, Michael!
Just when I said they're renowned for the Chudansuki, the reverse right-hand punch. He delivers one to the jaw of Marat Gafurov.
Starched Marat Gafurov, backing away, boom, landing the punch. Gafurov wobbles. Matsushima swarmed on him and landed two more.
Believe it, Gafurov's title aspirations have just been derailed by a one championship debutant.
Look at that. Boom, landed one, there was two, and then a few more. Look at this, just added a knee as he was getting up, and then boom, big uppercut, and then a few more just for good measure as Yuji Shimada steps in. Beautifully timed right hook as Gafurov was coming in, and then he finishes him off, lands the knee. Boom, one more right hand, one over the top. What a debut for Matsushima.
Gafurov looks absolutely gutted at the moment. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 41 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Koyomi Matsushima!
It's Garry Tonon looking ripped, stripped, and striated as a featherweight.
I like this drop down to featherweight. Ooh, nice little right hand. Expect Garry Tonon to spend some time on the feet. Watch his head movement. Watch how he bobs to the left and right. Looks a little bit like Mike Tyson out there, changing the levels, mixing things up. He's gonna drop down, threaten the takedown, but I think he wants to get experience on the feet. I think he wants to get some rounds in and just earn his pedigree on the feet.
Plenty of early switch stances here from Garry Tonon between southpaw and orthodox. Sung Jong Lee does have dynamite in his hands. We've seen him explode before. He tries for an overhand right. Tonon, long reach on the jab. Now goes southpaw back to orthodox. He'll keep switching. He'll look for ways to confound the Korean.
Sung Jong Lee doesn't really have that knockout power, but he's got punches together very well. I'm not really digging how Garry Tonon's lifting that back leg up when he throws that right hand, but he goes right into the takedown.
And here we are on the ground in Tononville.
Sung Jong Lee, look at it. He's lacing the legs. You can see Garry Tonon knows exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying, as you can see, Sung Jong Lee was trying to lock those legs around going against Kamashikarami, but Garry Tonon has had enough of it. Back up to his feet.
Sung Jong Lee had to put on the X guard to prevent the rising knees from Tonon. 8 week camp for Garry Tonon, focused on his boxing and his shoot boxing, working specifically on his jab. Tonon also said this one doesn't go past two rounds. Sung Jong Lee also an 8 week camp, working his boxing, wrestling, and takedown defense.
Come on, Garry!
Tonon's arms looking massive tonight. Those deltoids like a bunch of bananas. Threads the lead hand again. There's an uppercut off the rear hand from Tonon.
Yeah, Tonon looks sharp at this new weight class. Doesn't seem to be affected by the new weight cut.
The small cut under the left eye there of Tononich.
Looks like it looks a little bit like it, but I'd like to see, you know, Sung Jong Lee start going after those legs.
Uppercut almost took out the ring lights there from Tonon. Locked a boxing from the American here in the first round. Uppercut again misses the target. From the balls of his feet, fires a front kick to the face. Strike's not landing here for Tonon. Plenty of movement from him, goes down to the bread basket, then back up to the jawline. Front kick to the guts there from Tonon. Right hand just needed to turn it through a little more. left hook from zone, and it's all handiwork. Image, Garry Tonon.
I think Garry Tonon's got a lot of fans all over the world that are screaming at their TV sets right now, yelling that he needs to go for that takedown again.
Front kick there from Tonon. Patience being shown from Sung Jong Lee. Inside leg kick to that femoral profunda there from Tonon. You see the lunges coming down the left cheek of Tonon. Good right hand from Sung Jong Lee. As Tonon continues to switch darts, another uppercut misses the target.
See, he's got a little bit of damage on his face right there. He seems to be wearing it well, though. I see Sung Jong Lee start going after the leg kicks. He's not really throwing any kicks so far, so he's only giving Garry Tonon one thing to think about, and that's boxing.
Mitch Graman in only his third match. He looks tremendously confident, poised, precise, and enjoying himself, Garry Tonon. It's just how good he looks at this stage of his career.
I mean, it's, yes, but he's also got a lot. Oh, that's a beautiful sweep right there. He stepped in, hooked the leg, threw him on the canvas. But Sung Jong Lee was able to pop right back up. Garry Tonon has competed in hundreds of wrestling matches and hundreds of grappling matches, so he knows what it's like to be on the big stage. But under the ONE Championship lights, we gotta say he is performing exceptionally well, very relaxed, extremely confident.
I mean, even the way he just locked on the Muay Thai clinch of the high knee earlier on, putting together all the weapons in the mixed martial artist's arsenal. Garry Tonon, superb thus far. 35 seconds on the clock, dances off in a clockwise fashion, now drifts counterclockwise, picks up the chance again.
The stance is constantly switching from Garry Tonon, and it's very hard for Sung Jong Lee to get a read on it. He's having a hard time timing his punches as Garry Tonon closes the distance.
I think that Sung Jong Lee expected Tonon to come out striking. We all guessed he would, but the effectiveness of Tonon's jab so far has been superb.
His head move, look at the way he's pivoting around. He's moving his head very well. And he's got lots of energy, even though as he's dropping down, we don't allow weight cutting here at ONE Championship. So he's hydrated, he's fueled, he's ready to go at this new weight class. He looks great. Let's take a look at the shot that connected from Sung Jong Lee. Right here is Garry Tonon changed back to southpaw. Yep, right as he was coming back up, Sung Jong Lee landed a nice little uppercut that caught Garry Tonon on the eye. Sung Jong Lee needs to do more of that. He needs to engage those hands, mix in the leg kicks, give Garry Tonon something else to think about besides boxing. Garry Tonon does train at the Henzo Gracie Academy, surrounded by some of the best martial artists on the planet. And Henzo's over there looking cage side, looking very excited at how well his student is doing inside there, the one cage.
Garry Tonon, who actually began his grappling career in wrestling, was introduced to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu as a 14-year-old. Credits martial arts with helping him to deal with his ADHD. Never get the chance to talk to Garry Tonon. I tell you what, he is an enlightened man on so many subjects, and he'll talk to you for hours.
Ready?
Gentleman as well. Second round of three. Now, once again, both men said it would not go past two rounds. This is the round that Sung Jong Lee said he would knock out Garry Tonon in.
Sung Jong Lee's got to put that jab out there. He's got to ask Garry Tonon's closing the distance. Sung Jong Lee's got to utilize the jab. Garry Tonon's utilized throwing way too many jabs.
Counter right hand there from Sung Jong Lee. The head movement again from Tonon. The boxing has improved out of sight, particularly the jab of Tonon. High up against the balls of his feet, working the kicking arsenal now. There's a front kick to the midsection from the American. Dances back to center cage. Outside leg kick, inside leg kick. A striking display here, 101 from Garry Tonon.
This is a very different striker from the second time that we saw him.
You know what, Mitch, we're seeing the kicks here from Tonon, but Sung Jong Lee began his martial arts career in the national Korean art of Taekwondo, an art renowned for its kicking arsenal.
And he hasn't thrown a kick yet.
Nope. 2016 Naganogi Grappling Championship at under 160 pounds. Sung Jong Lee, purple belt in BJJ, loves the heel hook. Imagine slapping a heel hook on Garry Tonon. Don't think it'll happen. Let's see if he can swing for a knockout here in the second round. Garry Tonon, look at the movements on Tonon. Circles off clockwise, now drifts to his right. Full of confidence oozing out of every pore here for Garry Tonon. The jab, and oh, look at the evasion of the takedown. That was sweet. That was slick.
That was beautiful.
Up to finish.
Slid out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up the game.
Oh, this is trouble!
You don't want to give your neck to Garry Tonon. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But Sung Jung Lee did a good job there of swinging over into half guard. Got into side control, but look at Garry Tonon. He adjusted it in. Oh, that's there.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some Tonon in it. Garry Tonon does it again. He is 3-0, and he is looking simply superb.
Sung Jung Lee gave him too many opportunities with that choke. He got it once. Sung Jung Lee did a good job of moving around, trying to fight it off, but Garry Tonon got it twice, didn't quite have it. Third time, look at these adjustments. This is world-class grappling on display right here. He's like, nope, don't quite have it here. Let me make this minor adjustment. You come in over into me, I'm gonna let you come into me, and then I'm gonna take you on top, mount you, and then I'm gonna finish you.
If you go to ground with Garry Tonon, if you take a trip to Tononville, don't expect to leave. Sung Jung Lee found that out the hard way. And might I say, Garry Tonon prophetic. He said he'd finish Sung Jung Lee inside of 2 rounds. And he did just that. Garry Tonon suffers a little cut under the left eye. Great sportsmanship displayed by both these martial arts warriors. But it's Garry Tonon who in his MMA career now goes 3-0. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 4 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine, Garry Tonon!
England says you can knock Tonon out on the feet. Tonon says he can sub the Archangel on the ground. Let's see how it plays out here. Lots of movement early on from Garry Tonon. Already looking for a takedown. Tonon gets it. This is not where England wanted to be in the opening 20 seconds, Dragon.
Yeah, England had to be careful with those leg kicks. And you can see why. Tonon was able to catch the leg kick and use that to secure that single leg, turn the corner, and put England on his back. Now Tonon's in half guard, so let's see what England can do here. He's got to try to frame up the head and start to create space. He's immediately turned onto his side like this, and this is good. You don't want to allow Tonon to flatten him out. The thing is Tonon's so tricky. Look how he's attacking the leg. He's got that leg positioned. Good job by England to secure that, to keep that leg from getting caught. He was almost able to stand up there, but Tonon was able to close that gap and put him on his back. Now he slid over effortlessly into the mount. And look at that, the way Tonon slides him over into the cage. Now he's got him in his corner, and this is a bad spot for England to be in.
This represents a huge step up in opposition for Garry Tonon. At the moment, he is dominating Anthony England. England brings in an 8-5 mixed martial arts record with 4 submissions, 3 knockouts. 1 decision win. Tonon gives up the experience, but you wouldn't know at the moment. Takes the back, drills in the left hand.
And Michael, this is that grapple box that we were talking about earlier with Tonon. He's able to control these positions, isolate his limbs. Look at that, he's got his control on that far side, so he's pinned that arm to his side, and he's using the other arm to punch. England can only defend with one side here.
Tonon, who TKO'd Richard Corminal on debut. Rear naked choked Rahul Raju in the third, and guillotine Sung Jung Lee in the second. Make it a first round win over Anthony England here in Tokyo. Knees now from the Lion Killer.
Good job from England to get back up to his feet, but look at the way Tonon laced that leg to disrupt the balance of England. Look at that way he's tripping that leg out. There's so many things that England has to worry about right now. His arm, his right arm, is still pinned to his side. He can't use his right arm for anything. And Tony's using that other leg, his right leg, to disrupt the balance of him.
This is excellence from Garry Tonon. Incomplete control of Anthony England. big downward elbow to the top of the ear. There's one to the temple from Tonon, and those hurt. Just pops in a little uppercut, tucking under the beard of Anthony England. It's all one-way traffic. It's all Tonon so far, with 2:15 remaining in the first.
Look how he's placing that leg. It's like Tonon has four arms. He's using his arms to, his legs to control the legs and disrupt the balance of England, constantly sweeping him out and putting eventually England on his back. Now he's in half guard. He steps over with one side. Now he's going to easily get back into mount if he wants it. He might just use the stay here and pound on him.
The work rate, the technique, the aggression of the lion killer Garry Tonon. Hoping to pound out England inside the first round here. Still a long time to go, 1 minute 40. Another right hand. Chambers the left, switches back to the right. Has the back here of England. England desperately wanting to get back to his feet. He gets there now. Buckle Tonon too. He's still gonna hold it, drags him back down to the canvas, and here come the right hands, and here come the elbows.
Yeah, he's constantly attacking different limbs. You can see he's controlling the far side arm, he's just sweeping out the legs. He's got so many different weapons, and now he's in mount, and look for these punches to keep coming down. He controls them. He controls England in so many different ways, and he's able to maneuver him and put him in certain positions, any position that he wants.
You can sign the pink slips. You can sign the ownership papers. Because Garry Tonon has completely owned and dominated Anthony England here. England nowhere to go. Referee will make you right on top of the action. He may stop his turn. He does now. Garry Tonon goes 4-0 in his mixed martial arts career. And that was a win against his most credentialed opponent yet.
Wow, Tonon just manhandled his most dangerous opponent to date. Featherweight in one championship, you better be paying attention, because right now, Tonon just announced that he is a legitimate contender in one championship. Look at this. Just control, total domination coming from Garry Tonon. Look at this, just piecing up England. And then watch him lace these legs. Look how he's disrupting the balance here. Almost up to his feet, almost working his way back up. Tonon sucks the legs away, jumps on the back, and then just starts pounding. Look at the accuracy of these punches. He's splitting the guard. None of these are hitting the arm. All these things are sliding right through the guard of England. Good stoppage by the referee. Beautiful display of grapple boxing by Garry Tonon.
Tonon told us yesterday he wasn't going to waste time, and certainly he made short work of England. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 12 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Garry Tonon!
Garry Tonon undefeated 4-0. Can he go 5-0? Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson, Misha Tate with you. Tonon moving well early on, has improved his boxing out of sight in those last four matches. But let's see how he handles the power of Nakahara. Should Nakahara touch him, he tries with an early uppercut.
You know, Nakahara's got a very heavy left side. He's got a heavy left punch and a heavy left kick. So it's going to be key for Garry Tonon to try to keep his head on the outside lead hand of Nakahara. So that's what that head movement is. He's going to constantly be trying to shift his head to the outside hand of Nakahara. But Nakahara's got a good right hook, too.
Possibly switching stance here in the opening stage of the first round is Garry Tonon. If it goes to ground, both men are very well equipped, but of course, Tonon Gather is an utter genius in the gather at the moment. This is trouble for Nakahara. It's a four-ball! He's shot again! It was brilliant!
Well, that's just what we were going over the other day with the leg lock series. Incredibly impressive. I was thinking, you know, how is Garry going to get the takedown? He didn't need the takedown. He went to the ground himself. It doesn't matter whether you're standing or you're on the ground. With Garry Tonon, he's really on another level.
Misha, was there a cardinal mistake that Nakahara made in that first round?
Really, I think it was that just as soon as you see the elevation drop, you've got to realize you've got to disengage. As soon as that level change happened, he just stayed a little too close. But that's a very hard thing to read. You know, Tonon did a great job disguising it. You know, his level changes are something that's not easy to catch.
And Mitch, this is why Garry Tonon said to everyone, come at me now, because in a year's time, I will be truly unstoppable.
Yeah, look at the way he wraps up this leg. He gets that he triangles the leg, and then, but watch his right leg. Watch what he does with his right leg. He puts it on the shoulder of Nakahara, so Nakahara is not able to sit up and disengage with the hands. Look at that. He actually prevented him from sitting up and hand fighting with his own foot. That is some high-level jiu-jitsu.
I'm sure a lot of people expected Tonon to win, but nobody thought he'd do it that quickly.
No, absolutely. To go for a rolling heel hook is not something you typically see in martial arts, because if you stay down there in the wrong way, you tend to get hit in the face. Garry Tonon had it perfectly figured out, though. He used that foot beautifully to block the shoulder.
He is 5-0. Who can stop Garry Tonon? Let's make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 55 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of heel hook, Garry Tonon!
The karate gun against the freestyle. Big leg kicks to open up. Single leg takedown attempt here. Shoots in again. Matsushima hunting for a takedown with a pretty boy. Wanwanil staying on his feet. Can he work some taekwondo style?
Good scrambling to defend that single leg from Wanwanil. Matsushima not wanting much of the stand-up game in the first minute of this one.
Looping, swinging punches from both these men. Wanwanil high up with the balls on his feet. Looping punch again from the Korean. Shoots in for a double, driving across the ring. Takedown there from Matsushima.
Finally able to get that takedown on the third attempt. Third time's a charm for Matsushima now. He's trying to suck the hips away from the ropes. Wanwanil's trying to push that head down, work his way back up to his feet.
Downward elbow, side of the head there from Wanwanil, back up to his feet in the corner. Let's go with a single leg to Matsushima. Looping left hand, trips off to center ring, outside thigh kick from the Japanese.
Wanwanil keeping his chin nice and tucked there as he's landing a few shots. Beautiful punch combination there. Landed on Matsushima as Matsushima goes into the body lock.
Matsushima, a Kyokushin karate black belt, renowned as the hardest style of karate, founded by Sosei Masoyama, a man who famously competed in a 300-man kumite, 100 opponents per day over 3 days and defeated them all. Passed away, if I remember, in 1993. Strong style still exists in so many of these Kyokushin athletes.
Wanwanil is tough to hold down. Matsushima's he's able to get the takedown. That's two that he's gotten, but Wanwanil's able to pop right back up.
Another failed takedown attempt there from Matsushima. Wanwanil was hoping to rise the knee on the break there. Left hook, both been trained. Overhand right from Matsushima. Long overhand right, overextended on it. No counter though from Wanwanil. 2:50 remains, set for 3 rounds of action. Jumping knee and a high knee for the Muay Thai clinch from Wanwanil. The downward elbow to the clavicle.
Matsushima's nice and tight on that body lock. Again, turns away from the corner, puts Wanwanil on his back. Let's see if Matsushima's trying to stay nice and tight, not giving Wanwanil any space to create a scramble. Wanwanil is very tough to hold down, but if Matsushima is going to want to do any damage or advance his position, he's going to have to give him a little bit of room to start working some ground and pound submissions.
A lot of instructions coming from the corners of both Matsushima and Wanwanil. Side control butts him off there as Wanwanil. Matsushima straight back on top of the Korean athlete. Chance for the knees, but Wanwanil breaks off nicely, Greg.
And he's hard to hold down, man. Just that little bump, he was able to pop right back up.
Mitch, the pace of this one in the opening round has been fierce.
Yeah, they are definitely moving at a high clip. You can start to see Matsushima get nice and tight on that back. Let's see if Wanwanil can work his way back up to the feet as he tries to roll through.
High knee there from Matsushima. Let's see if we see some Moushigo roundhouse kicks from the Kyokushin Karateka in the grey trunks. It's an overhand right instead. In Kyokushin Karate, They are not allowed to punch to the face. You can kick to the head, of course, but you're not allowed to tournaments. A lot of great Kyokushin strikers over the years. The likes of Andy Hook, Semi Schilt, Slamham Sam Bricker, Claudio Feitosa, Francisco Filio. The ex-martial arts, George St. Pierre. The list goes on. Driving takedown across the ring again there from Matsushima. Is this the right game plan from Matsushima?
I like the game plan from Matsushima. He's mixing things up and he's not allowing any room for Kwon Won Il to start letting go of those hands. Kwon Won Il has beautiful punching combinations. He's got a very heavy right hand. And now he's forcing Kwon Won Il to work at this incredible pace that he's setting.
Under 30 seconds remaining of what has been a fabulous back and forth opening round. There has been no breathing space. Neither man has given the other an inch, a millimeter.
Several takedowns that Matsushima landed, just like that one right there. But he's also making Kwon Won Il think about defending these takedowns constantly, so he's not able to settle into his striking game.
End of the round, we go to the towels. Good opening round with the takedowns from Koyomi Matsushima. Of course, under these global rule set, we do score on an overall bounce and not round by round.
There's a nice little punch and exchange as Kwon Won Il just barely missing with a few shots. And then Matsushima driving in for the takedown. I don't think he was able to get that one, but then we saw a beautiful flying knee attempt that landed by Kwon Won Il. Matsushima just marched right through it. Matsushima's not wanting to strike as much as we thought he was going to want to do. You know, being a karate black belt, but we are seeing a lot of different elements to his game, and that's the takedown game.
We talk about the karate skills of Matsushima, but let's not forget he's also a FILA World Grappling Championship silver medalist, Shooto welterweight rookie tournament winner. The man trains alongside the former deep lightweight champion, Satoru Kitaoka. A powerhouse in every sense of the word. Superb wrestling to go along with his superb karate technique on Koyomi Matsushima. Second of three. 1-1 Il in the pink and brown. Taekwondo black belt BJJ blue belt. 6 centimeters taller than the Japanese opponent. Kwon Won Il's Taekwondo does give him a varied kicking arsenal. Taekwondo is a sport and martial arts centered around kicking techniques, particularly if you're looking at WTF Taekwondo, the Olympic style of Taekwondo. It's all about kicks. But we're not seeing much of that coming to play from Kwon Won Il so far tonight.
Usually see the Taekwondo influence coming from more of his footwork and his movement. That's where he gets cut those angles and creates those minute little details to land those shots, especially when it comes to the boxing. What we're seeing right now is just him getting out grappled, and Matsushima's staying nice and tight, making Kwon Won Il work, sucking the power out of his hands. Nice little knee length there as Kwon Won Il tried to get back up. Matsushima's giving no room to let go of some of those hands.
3 minutes 45 remain, second round of three. The first was set at a furious pace. The second so far, much more methodical from both these athletes.
Yeah, it'd be tough to maintain that pace that they had in that first round. And Matsushima's trying to wear on Kwon Won Il. Beautiful turn the corner there to put Kwon Won Il on his back.
Only the one loss for Kwon Won Il, first round heel hook submission to the great Masakazu Imanari. Back on February 22nd, 9-1, record 5 knockouts, 1 submission. The sub was a rear naked choke of Sung Kyung Kim back in August 2015. The KOs include that 19-second stunner over Aaron Kelly on April 12.
Kwon Won Il's got the back, man. Matsushima's got the back of Kwon Won Il. And this is a much slower pace, a much more grinding pace that Matsushima's inflicting on Kwon Won Il. He's staying a lot tighter. We're not seeing those explosions that we saw in the first round from Kwon Won Il. Matsushima's just slowing down, working on those legs. Good job by Kwon Won Il to escape and get back into the center of the ring.
Uppercut attempted off the left hand there from Kwon Won Il. Outside thigh kick from Matsushima. Gets underneath the right hand. Single leg here from the Japanese.
Kwon Won Il's
look at a choke, modified guillotine. He's driving for it right now. He might have it.
And the pretty boy final finish in the second round. The crowd believes he can. Someone who believes he can. Matsushima has other ideas. He's inside control, Matsushima.
Now he's working inside control. He was trying to stay nice and tight. Juan is going to try to turn to his side, turtle up, work his way back up. Can he do it? Good job by Matsushima to use his knee to prevent that. Juan is able to get back up.
Matsushima staying glued to the pretty boy.
Those knees, those elbows hurt. Thudding to the side of the temple. Good job turning the corner, putting Juan down again.
A lot of wrestling tonight from Matsushima. 1-1-0, a little turtle shell here. What are the options for Matsushima Dragon?
He's trying to secure the back. He's gonna try to get one hook in there, but Juan Wanil's doing a good job of defending. I think he's just trying to drag him out, wear him down, trying to get taking deep water, because before Matsushima came to one championship and before he scored that, you know, that first round knockout of Gafurov, this is what Matsushima was known for. He had three decision wins where he just outworked his opponents, going for the takedowns. And we saw him debut in such highlighted fashion by knocking out Gafurov. We didn't even see this type of game from him. But this is what Matsushima did to make a name for himself in Japan. Just outworking opponents, grinding on them, utilizing these takedowns and smothering them at the top.
Half guard position, 40 seconds remains, second of three here. Inside the sold-out Baoshan Arena in Shanghai, China. It's one championship legend request wherever you're watching. In over 140 countries around the world. We hope you're enjoying all this fantastic martial arts action. Big hello to our Japanese viewers on Abima TV in Japan, supporting no doubt their man, Koyomi Matsushima. High guard here from Juan Wanil. This is how the round is going to end. We are going into the deep water. We are going in to the third and final.
Yeah, you can start to see Juan Wanil. He doesn't want to end up on his back anymore. He wants to stay away from that clinch. I'd expect to see Juan Wanil start to throw more uppercuts and knees down the middle once Matsushima starts to attack that single leg, because that's what we saw from him in the first, is this constant hunt for this takedown. Look at the way that he's controlling him from the bottom. We're not seeing these explosions coming from Juan Wanil. There's a nice little knee landed by Matsushima inside the corner there as Juan Wanil was working his way back up to his feet.
And there he is, Lu Wei, the former national basketball captain in the house, along with our many luminaries here ringside at the Baoshan Arena, enjoying all the goodness of one championship martial arts action. Koyomi Matsushima versus Juan Wanil. A fantastic match brought to you by Spring Airlines. And who's got the spring in their step? Who's going to fly at home in the third and final round for the victory here? Glittering crowd. Sold out weeks ago. Full to the rafters here in Shanghai on a beautiful Saturday night. Shooting for a safety. Matsushima.
Again, this is what Juan Wanil is going to have to deal with, and he's so young in his mixed martial arts career. He's only 23. If he does, you know, get outworked here in the third and final round, he's not able to score. He's only going to have to do this. You know, that's what he did against when he lost to Imanari. You know, he wanted to work on his submission defense, and that's what he's done. He hasn't been submitted, but he is getting out-wrestled, and that's what he's going to have to go back, and he's going to have to solve this problem. Deal with these high-level grapplers that are constantly on you and not giving you any space to breathe.
What is Matsushima looking to do here, Dragon?
Well, he's trying to advance his position. That's why he has the legs triangled. He's just trying to really hold on to him. We haven't seen a lot of submission attempts. We haven't really even seen him, you know, when he has this position here in the back, try to advance and, you know, show off ground control. He's not trying to advance his position. He's kind of just trying to shut down Matsushima, Juan Wanil. You can see how he has the legs triangled, working into side control. Now, he's probably just going to try to stay nice and tight. A avoid the scramble attempt by Kwon Wanil. Kwon Wanil's trying to turn his back to create the scramble, but Matsushima's just kind of holding on to him, just kind of out-wrestling him, out-working on him.
Once again, folks, we are scoring this one as an overall contest, not round by round. Referee Kim Cheng just warning Kwon Wanil not to hold the ropes. He wants to see a little more action here, this Cheng.
This has got to be very frustrating for Kwon Wanil, just to try to deal with this constant, you know, grappling from, you know, Matsushima. You know, you can see he's going to triangle the legs here, stay nice and tight. Kwon Wanil's going to try to scoot his legs out, get rid of this triangle that he's got to deal with.
So how does Kwon Wanil change it up here, man? How does he try and swing the pendulum and reignite himself?
You can see he's trying everything he can, but he's got to create space. He has to go chest to chest, start pushing that head down, and get Matsushima off of him. Now he's got that little bit of a break. I think that what Kim Chang's just going to restart it there in the middle. And he's got to try to create that space. He can't do it because Matsushima's just not giving him any space to breathe. As Kwon Wanil tried to jump through the ropes.
Inside the guard now, Kwon Wanil. The crowd liked that one. Bird's eye view there on the close guard of Kwon Wanil.
This is going to be a great lesson for Kwon Wanil, how to deal with this type of suffocating grappler who doesn't give you that room. Look, Kwon Wanil's got his feet on the hips, try to push away, but you see how close Matsushima is, just holding onto him. He doesn't want to engage in the stand-up battle with Kwon Wanil. Kwon Wanil is going to have to threaten more positions, threaten more submissions here. Give Matsushima something to think about. Threaten him with these, maybe dive for the leg locks, but throw up submissions so Matsushima just isn't so comfortable here sitting in his guard.
Four more matches still to come here tonight at ONE Championship Legendary Quest, including the big one, our main event for the ONE Super Series Adamant Muay Thai World Title. Stan Fairtex, Alma Unico, and also the return of the legend, Sexyama, Yoshihiro Akiyama, and Agalantani.
Kwon Wanil is trying to put his feet on the hips. He's trying to push away, but Matsushima is just too strong. He's just too tight. He's giving him no room to breathe.
45 seconds now. Trying to create space there to return to his feet. Kwon Wanil posted up on the left arm, but couldn't get there once again. Tying up the legs, Matsushima now gives them up. What's he looking to do here?
He's trying to do the same thing. He's trying to take his legs, triangle them, keep between them. A good job by Kwon Wanil to get back up to his feet. Matsushima just goes back to the body lock. Probably gonna trip, take him down. He might pick him up and put him back down. Transitions into a high crotch. You can see just how effective Matsushima's style would be in a cage where your opponent couldn't go anywhere, couldn't move anything. But in a ring, it's just that you know, it creates that space. Again, Kwon Wanil's going for that choke of his, but Matsushima's just right there on top, shutting it down.
We are going down to the judges here in Shanghai. A final flurry from Matsushima, a knee to the side of the head. We've gone the full three, and wherever you're watching around the world, in over 140 countries, do you score it for Matsushima? Do you score it for Kwon Wanil? The respect, the martial arts code of honor, the Bushido spirit between these two fabulous athletes. Big takedown from the wrestler there.
Matsushima picking him up, putting him down right in the center, so Kwon Wanil would not be able to utilize the corner of the ring to work his way back up to his feet, which he was able to successfully do in the first round. But as the match wore on, just that crushing style of grappling just got the better of him, and Matsushima was able to control all the grappling exchanges and stay away from the big power punches of Kwon Wanil.
And a win earlier on tonight for Team Japan, Itsuki Arata on her pro debut against Angelique Sabano with a first round sub. The Koreans also had a win earlier on, Yoon Chang-min over Trestle Tan by first round knockout. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards.
All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Koyomi Matsushima.
We'll have to rely on that speed and power. Six knockouts, one submission, 70% finishing rate. Undefeated pro boxing, undefeated amateur mixed martial arts as well for the Taekwondo black belt, running a four-match win streak coming in tonight. High kick there from Matsushima, overhand right. Ninja slows him down. They go to the canvas now. Matsushima side control early.
Oh, beautiful takedown, but immediately Kim starts to look for that single leg, but Matsushima's doing a good job of having that headlock control and controlling the position of Kim. Matsushima's dangerous from this position, especially with those knees.
Bully Moushigo, Matsushima, 11-4, six knockouts, one submission, 64% finishing rate. And a Kyokushin karate black belt. Two of the big martial arts stars against each other here on the feet, Kyokushin and Taekwondo. But they're on the ground inside the opening 1 minute 30. Now back to their feet. Will we see a spin around or another takedown from Matsushima? Backs him off with a left hand, circles counterclockwise. Outside side kick, overhand right, jumping knee! And looks for a takedown again as Matsushima sits him in the corner, nicely done.
Nice jumping knee there attempt by Kim. As Matsushima was able to catch it and put him on his backside, you can see Kim's trying to hit the switch by reaching between the legs there of Matsushima, but Matsushima's doing a good job, and this is what he does. He likes to triangle the legs, press you up against the corner, and just beat on you.
Matsushima in control. Staying calm and composed is Kim. Matsushima, can he find submission number two? The Shooto Welterweight Rookie Tournament winner. Trying to get back to his feet is Kim in the genuflect position at the moment. Under 3 minutes remains. Looking to wrench in the canvas from belly to back here is Matsushima and gets him down again. And Kim immediately back to his feet, almost takes a high knee and a two-punch combination from the Korean.
Good job by Kim to work his way back up to his feet. It was kind of reminiscent of what Matsushima did to Kwon Won Il. Just those relentless takedowns, constantly putting his opponent on his back as he
hits him out
the rope.
Boom, shakalaka! Beautifully done from Matsushima, goes to side control dragon.
How strong is Matsushima, Michael? That was just brute force. He snatched him from in between the ropes, picked him up onto his shoulder, and took him for the ride. Now he's in side control. Laces that head with his right hand, might look to switch and look to pass, mount.
Mentioned there a revenge factor in this one, given that Matsushima has the win over Kwon Won Il of Korea.
Yeah, I definitely think so. You know, Kwon Won Il is in the corner of Kim. So there's guys, he's like his little brother. These guys are so close. Watch him around the hotel all week.
Tried to throw the high knee and the get up there did Kim. 140 remains, first round of 3-3, an absolute cracker. Big right hand. To the solar plexus, didn't quite find the target. Nice little shot there from Kim. Be careful not to telegraph that lead hand, Kim. Takes an inside fly kick. The roundhouse kick in the Washigeti of the Karateka in the white. Taekwondo stylist in the red. Can we see some Taekwondo kicks from Kim?
You can see the stance of Matsushima. He kind of leads with his face, and when he shoots, he dives in head forward, and that's what Kim's trying to do with these jumping switch knees. Also expect him to start timing that uppercut as well, because he knows Matsushima puts everything into his takedowns. He goes full tilt boogie, trying to put you on your back, so he might leave himself open to a possible attack coming inside.
Adding side kick, Yokogeri to the lead thigh there from Matsushima. Oh, the overhand right, and for the headache maker.
That's what he caught Gafurov with. He's got good timing on that overhand right once you step into his range.
Matsushima looking incredibly sharp in the opening round. 25 seconds to go. Now pulls down, goes for another one. Getty sidekick, switches to orthodox. The karate stylings of Matsushima. Kim looks to cut off the ring. Matsushima goes into the lead hand, away from the power side of Kim. Cracks the inside side of that femoral profunda. Inside leg again, and that finishes a very good first round for Matsushima. Folks, don't forget, give us a follow on all your social media platforms, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube at ONE Championship. And don't forget to play the world's largest martial arts fantasy game in the ONE Super app. It's ONE Fantasy on there. 64% advance tipping Koyomi Matsushima for the win tonight.
Beautiful takedowns. That first attempt was almost an Osoto Gotti as he was able to reap out that leg, but then that double leg was just blasting through. Here's where he picks him up, and this is just the sheer strength of Matsushima. To pick up Kim like that, to put him down, that is some serious power. But that is what Matsushima is known for. There's that monstrous right hand. He can do it on the ground, but he can also do it on his feet. You can see just how much that kind of that five-round beatdown from, it was only a two-round beatdown by Martin Nguyen that put on really helped him learn about himself and become a better athlete from it.
Second round of a scheduled three. Round two to open up off of the leg. Now switches to southward as Matsushima. Back to orthodox. Trying to confound Kim of Korea. Jam to overhand right from Matsushima. Good right hand lead there from Kim. Hand power, no mustard bar. Kim on the front foot now. There's the kicking arsenal. There it is from Kim. A little flush of taekwondo. Big right hand from Matsushima. Backs him off. That kick from Kim. Dancing now the career. There's a high kick. Gonna see some more kicks coming to play now from Kim.
Now Kim's starting to touch Matsushima. It's because of his stance. It's the way that he leans forward with that head. Martin Nguyen just packs a little bit more of a punch, and it's what put Matsushima down over and over again. So here, with Kim, he's got to time that shot. A, he's got to avoid the takedown, and he's got to get back up to his feet.
Time here for Kim. Figure out the rhythm of Matsushima.
Look at the way Matsushima handcuffed the hand behind Kim's back. See what he's going to do with it. Might try to turn him onto that side. Good job by Kim to get that out and work his way back up to his knee.
One knee is Kim.
There's that switch. He's trying to hit it. Good job by Matsushima to see it coming.
Curling knee there for Matsushima. Doubles up and then Kim gets out of danger. Center in now. Shoots in. Good stuff there from Kim. Nice popping left hand. Doubles up and it's his Kim. Matsushima wants to get on the inside, put hands on him and take him down again. Kim on the front foot now, getting cornering, unload the heavy artillery, off the hand.
You can see the way Matsushima shoots in, his head is wide open for these shots. He's got to cover up, he's got to keep his hands glued to the side of his head, because Kim's touching him in these wild exchanges.
Kim takes the back standing. Under 3 minutes to go now. Second round of three. First round into Matsushima, though it is scored as an overall contest, not round by round. Matsushima skipping outside leg kick. Kim hunting ball for liver. Matsushima not afraid to drift into the power side of the Korean. Doesn't respect that right side of Kim. Good overhand right, drops it. Matsushima, Hanafi strikes the ground and pound. Is at the beginning of the end for Kim. He's taking punishment. Tries to advance his position. There's Matsushima. Kim throws the legs out.
Good job by Kim to recover. If that head comes forward, he's looking to time that big right hand. He puts everything into that monstrous shot and was able to sit down Kim. Kim is immediately starting to look for attacks off his back, looking for a possible triangle. See him trying to control the wrist and shove that arm through. But Matsushima's wise, dude, knows exactly what he's trying to do. He's going to shut down that attempt and just sit there and guard and recover.
Lots of instructions from the corner of Matsushima, amongst them the crazy koala, Kitioro Sikoroka. Great to see Kitioro here tonight. Inside the open guard of Kim.
Is that the crazy koala? Drops a little bit of ground and pound. Good first 10 minutes from Koyomi Matsushima, but now this is Kim's spot. Kim's not even taking a seat during this exchange. This is deep water, right, ladies and gentlemen. This is a long match so far. High energy expenditure coming on by both these guys. This is Kim's shot. He knows that a takedown's coming. Look for a big flying knee coming out of Kim.
Taekwondo black belt versus Kyokushin karate black belt. Kim Jae Woong of Korea looking to keep the streak alive and go five on the trot. Koyomi Matsushima looking to establish his name once again in the featherweight ranks, the heated featherweight ranks of one championship. Overhand right, smack back on the kisser. And Kim momentarily does the chicken dance. He tags him again. Here comes Matsushima. Here comes the onslaught. The barrel. The hammer fist strikes. Him in all sorts of bother. Hemching on top of the action, he stops it. Matsushima pounds him out in the third round. It began with the right hand standing and finished with the ground and pound.
That right hand of Koyomi Matsushima is a serious weapon, ladies and gentlemen. The way that he leans into it, his timing and accuracy are beautiful. Puts Kim down for the third time, just beautifully done on that overhand right. And then the finishing instincts kick in from Matsushima, jumps all over Kim, and just puts a beat down on him in the first minute of that third round. What a performance from Koyomi Matsushima. Here's that ground and pound where Kemp Chang was keeping a close eye on the action and was forced to jump in and save Kim Jae Woong. But what a performance by Koyomi Matsushima.
Explosive striking is what Matsushima is all about. You saw it there. The right hand started it, explosive indeed. The ground and pound finished it. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 24 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout,